went into the shade, but you can still see the baboon there.
I'd rather see the other hand there. Oh, yeah.
Here's mother baboon with a baby riding on its back. Large herd of Cape buffalo. About as large as one I have seen. And they're not afraid of anybody.
See, the lion's fame. So many lions.
A lot of lions over there.
There's one in 10 peeking out around the tree.
Yeah, he's looking.
He's looking.
Where?
Right over here to the right.
Oh, to the right?
Yep, they're looking at him. There's
three lions. At the base of a tree. A beautiful action here, looks like. Be looking at this giraffe, but I doubt it. It's just a coincidence. They happen to be close together.
They haven't looked around over this way.
It's strange they don't care what we are.
Concentrating on supper.
Really looking. There's one, two, three, four, five, six lines right here. Where is it?
Right out here. A lead line out there.
Way out here?
To your left. To your left in front of it. Tail just swished.
Right.
Yeah.
I see one, two, three, four, five, six. but I can't see the seventh one. Just keep standing there and eating on the top of the thorn bush.
Sure, bear views him. He looks right down at him.
Yeah, I don't think he's really much concerned. This probably goes on all the time. Just peaceful coexistence.
Yeah.
This is an acacia tree with an eagle's nest right in the top. The eagle just sat down on the nest, so it may not be able to pick her up. But right there, where the nest is, she settled down on some eggs, apparently.
Okay.
This ostrich has just been running and feigning wounding, fell down and everything. Her nest must be nearby.
She must have a nest close by. She gets up, runs, falls.
I want to know what I want to
do. How is it?
Right.
Gordon. This is Sunday, October 21st. Sunrise out of the sun there. This is supposed to be three cheetah out there under that tree. I don't know whether it will show up or not. I'm as far as I can get on the telephoto.
That one's really small.
Can you take a picture through one
eye?
They say it would be a fine to drive out on the grass to get to these cheetahs, so we're just having to take a shot here.
We didn't bring anything. We had delicious for breakfast.
That baboon's really a ham.
There's one with this one on the back. See it?
So
it's the bone in the mouth.
He's a big one.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, what's on the menu for today? These are Thompson Gazelle. Pretty nice little herd of them. We're just a little ways out of Serenera Lodge on the way to Gorongor Crater for lunch. After getting out of the lying down in the mail? Right up on them now. Probably within 10, 15 feet. And they don't seem to mind. And to think that this may be an extinct animal one day. In the wild, at least. This is the marker on the upper rim of the Gorongor crater. It says, he gave all he possessed, including his life, for the wild animals of Africa. Apparently he died January the 10th, 1969. He was born April the 12th, 1934. Michael Rizimek. And here's the gorge that he apparently discovered. A huge lake right down in the center of the crater. Jungle on the outer rim of the Gorongor crater. It just really looked like Africa, or the way I thought Africa should look. We're probably 8,000 feet up in the air. And it's just jungle everywhere.